Hi, this is Lynn Susek. It's my red lipstick on. I think I'm gonna delete yesterday's. There's been 5 views of it, and I messed up by talking about, I said mayor. I kept saying mayor, but I was talking about the governors. We're in a faith battle. I'm talking about faith versus science and calling the believers to make a decision. Choose ye this day whom you will believe. Choose whose report you will believe. Before this hour that we're in with the coronavirus, we've been able to believe, sort of split our beliefs and survive. And now it's becoming more evident you've got to make a decision for your health and your future, and the real gospel has to be preached. The real gospel is, you know, what's being preached in church until now has been mostly false religion, false God, that Jesus didn't really die for our sicknesses, he just died for our sins. And we've been surviving with, you know, believing in medicine. I'm not saying that there's been no place for medicine, that we couldn't, you know, use herbs and I mean, most faith preachers say thank God for the medical community, because a lot of people would have died without them because they don't have any faith. And I know. But now, you know, when medical knowledge doesn't work, you're left to either perish or, you know, start looking to faith. And faith is where it was at in the first place. Jesus died for our sins and our sicknesses, but, you know, if you were raised like me, where we didn't know that was true or how to believe that to be true, we considered it to be spiritual diseases and it not really the diseases. So unfortunately, we're getting to an hour where we have to make that decision and realize we need the real truth of the gospel to come to the surface and have people hear it worldwide and hear that your health depends on your faith, and your faith in God is your salvation. It is your salvation for healing and living life. So yeah, people die for lack of knowledge of this truth. My people perish for lack of knowledge is what the Bible says, because without the knowledge of the truth, you cannot have the faith to believe for wellness and healing, and that God, you know, the right way to do it, believing in the promises of God and speaking them, and, you know, claiming no plague comes nigh my dwelling. And we've got testimony after testimony with Andrew Womack Ministries and Curry Blake, which is John G. Lake Ministries, and all the testimonies that you want to find, where people, this is how you do it. If you find out you have something, you resist. You say, okay, thank you for that diagnosis. I'm not gonna believe in that and submit to it. I'm gonna resist, and it's not gonna come nigh my dwelling anymore. So anyway, I'm not gonna explain it all in one teaching, but there are people, if you don't like this teaching, you know, don't listen. I'm offering something that people need to hear if they're willing. But yeah, you know, people get offended because their loved ones have passed away, and I'm saying it's because of lack of knowledge. I have loved ones that passed away too, but I could have passed away if I didn't know this. I've had several encounters with death, and I've resisted, praise God, and I'm still resisting something in my life that needs to go away and be changed. However, you know, I'm very healthy because of what I believe. So yesterday I was talking about Governor Cuomo. I think he's governor, I don't know, I don't even say which state, but he made a declaration on April 14th that God has nothing to do with the beating of this virus. And as a Christian, you have to ask yourself, is that what you believe? If you believe in science and medicine as your salvation for health, then you believe that God has nothing to do with it. Now, if you want to believe both, it's going to only last so long before you're confronted with which way are you, what's your faith in. So he made that declaration, and it really slaps the Christians in the face and says, wake up, what do you believe? So I, being in Michigan, we've been confronted with what do we believe, and I'm getting just disappointed and frustrated with the Christians that I know, and the lack of understanding or real belief in God protecting us by faith, because they've bought into medical beliefs. And you know, when you run out of medical beliefs, then what? I believe now in total health and faith, by faith. And I've learned how to grab onto the promises of God and claim them and speak them and proclaim them and put them on my t-shirts, no plague come nigh my dwelling. And I'm not afraid of getting anything. I'm not afraid. I don't want to wear a mask. And I am all for fighting for our freedoms. We are really mad, many of us, with the governor of Michigan putting more and more restrictions on us, like as if we could really. It's just a delusion to me. It's the way we're doing the 6 feet apart and masks and trying to control this through physical means, and it's just it's a total farce. It's a total hoax, because a lot more people would be getting sick, a lot more people would be dying, and their excuse in the medical field is, I've heard of herd immunity, that people are becoming immune to it. It's just like, I don't want to hear all of your reasonings. The thing that's becoming more evident, the thing that medical doesn't factor in because they don't know, is faith. Okay, so when they do a study to find out what's going to work, you know, they don't have faith factored in, so they get confused when they, you know, when they say, okay, these 100 people, we're going to give them this medicine that they have the virus, and they don't ask them if they're praying, they don't ask them if they believe what they believe in healing, but you know, people are taking the medicine, and all of them don't get well, they don't know what to think of that. Or if they all did get well, they also need to know, well, was it the medicine or their immunity? Just did they just got better and fought it out themselves? It's just because they're not using all the information available. They're not using the information that's the true factor. How many people are in faith? So I pray that the Christian community in the world is going to get wise to how to live by faith. This is the last hour. Medicine and science isn't going to cut it for you. Medicine and science is not our God. It's not our salvation. We've been mixing our faith, splitting it, double-minded between science, the natural mind that's carnal, and faith in God. But because you ask God to do it for you and don't see results, you turn to medicine. When God says, I did give you authority over snakes and scorpions, over deadly poison, over sickness, and you take authority, you speak life. And if you take God's word and speak it, it will be life to your flesh. And we will see more and more miracles on a regular basis. Start learning how, and you will see results, and we can get rid of the double-mindedness that the church suffers from. Okay, praise the Lord. So, I might delete yesterday's. I was talking about Mayor Cuomo and Mayor Whitmer. Sorry about that. It's the governors. The governors that I'm not, that I'm coming against, and we in Michigan, thousands protested this stay-at-home thing, and my beef with it is, I believe in by faith, and I should have the right to do that. But, you know, with everybody believing that it could get them, and you don't even have to have symptoms, you know, that you can infect other people, it's just getting crazy. Because if we take our own health into our own hands through science, there's just going to be fear. That's what you're left with. Because we're not God. I mean, if you are in God's kingdom, then God works with you and through you, and nothing is impossible to you. But without God, you know, you're left with just science. That's not going to work. Thanks for listening, and stay calm and speak life.